Yeah, so thank you, ITB, and thank you everyone for giving me a chance coming today to talk about responsible travel in Vietnam. My name is Sun, I'm coming from Footprint Travel. We are a small local tour operators in Vietnam, which are specializing in inbound travel in Vietnam and a little bit of Laos and Cambodia. From the very first start of Footprint Travel, we understand that it's important to do responsible travel. And we feel that as another travel company, we have to take care of the environment, culture, and also the local economy. And we believe that if we don't make it good to the environment, to conserve the culture, and so to care about the economy of the local communities, and then it's not going to be good for our resources, for our travel activities. Yeah. And we've been doing so far for around 9 years, and it has been a great successful from what we're doing, and everyone like it. Especially we've gained the trust and the happiness from different communities and places, attractions in Vietnam. Like in Ha Long Bay, one of the most beautiful places in Vietnam, and the Sapa Mountain places in the northwest of Vietnam. People are very happy to welcome our guests. And I just say to my colleagues, to everyone, that Footprint Travel and many other travel companies in Vietnam is just a bridge between the traveler and the local people, the host community. If we don't do a good job as a host, and we're not going to be successful in our businesses. So that's just some brief information about ourselves, what we're doing. And now I leave it to you for questions, open questions.
My name is Manik Mehta.
Yep.
I'm based in New York.
Mm-hmm.
There's a lot of interest in Vietnam, actually. But since this is a narrowly focused show concentrating on Asia,
mm-hmm.
how do you target markets within Asia? Which are your primary markets?
For going to travel market, I, to be honest, this is the second time that I've been to, and to ITB is the first time. My core objective this time is to come in and to sort of like networking, to meet friends and meet some other tour operators. And we haven't been making any big focus on the Asian market yet, but we understand that we see that we are operating in Vietnam, one of the South Asian countries in Asia, and it's so important to have some principle and some sort of like education activities for the Asian market. Yeah,
but Vietnam is a fascinating product in terms of its I use the word virginity,
mm-hmm.
As far as discovering the country's concern.
Yep.
And given the increasing wealth of Asians, particularly China, also in the ASEAN region and India,
mm-hmm.
I would imagine that this is a prime source of tourism traffic.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah.
Please go on.
Yeah, just to tell you that Vietnam, compared to other countries, other neighboring countries like Laos and Cambodia, and we have a really lot of attraction, from historical site to beautiful nature landscape, national parks, nature reserve, and we have 54 ethnic minorities, 54 members of the great Vietnam, and we have diverse cultures. Especially if you go to the northwest of Vietnam, you really see something like so lively, so colorful. And not only that area, but also throughout the country, you find a lot of interesting things. So we find that the growth of Vietnam tourism without responsible tourism plan would make it difficult to control, because it's going to be a very big destination, popular destination in the next few years. What I believe from the potential Vietnam has to offer. So, did you get my answer yet?
I heard your answer.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. No, it's if it's not in the, into the point, sorry, my English is not that perfect to understand.
I believe you speak good English.
Thank you.
Where do your customers come from primarily, and do they come directly into Vietnam first, or are they transiting through, coming in through another country such as Thailand?
Mm-hmm. We got about like 50% from Australia and New Zealand, and then about 20% from North America, and then Europe. We got about 10% somewhat from Asia. And people often go transiting through Thailand. Lots of travelers, lots of our customers from footprint travelers coming through Thailand. They've been to Thailand for a week or two, and they do so Laos and Cambodia. But normally they do Thailand, Vietnam, and all the way down to Saigon, and then pop into the Mekong with Cambodia and Laos.
You said 20% come from North America?
Yes, about 20%.
Are these really tourists, or these are people who go there for emotional reasons, like checking out background of relatives who have been growing up in Vietnam, they left behind, mm-hmm. so to say?
Actually, in those 20%, I would say it's going to be about 10 out of 20% of that American coming to Vietnam is for that purpose of looking for some relatives.
So the remaining 10% are genuine tourists?
Yes, about 10% to that one, and the rest is 90% is for visiting purposes.
For a first-time visitor to Vietnam, they can enter the country, if they're coming by air, they could enter via Saigon or Ho Chi Minh or Hanoi. What would you recommend a traveller to do? Would you recommend them to arrive in Hanoi and then travel south, either by air or an alternative route? Or would you advise them to arrive in Ho Chi Minh and make their way north, either by air or another route? What would you recommend?
Actually, tourism has something has some differences, and it depends on the taste. Like if you are on a table with lots of food and you like something else and I like something else, and so I might want to go to the north because it has something unique with the weather, it's changing. But some people like it's convenient and it's more likely in Saigon from Ho Chi Minh City. So I've seen a lot of people flying from Bangkok, from a lot of places to Saigon first, before they ended up in Hanoi. But I would suggest that if it's convenient for you, then you can just make it Saigon. Or if you're just looking for something like an old French style and Halongay and some tribal people in the mountain area, then I would suggest you to land in Hanoi first, which is giving you some time to explore the town of Hanoi and going down to Halongay or going up to Sapa, the mountain area.
Have you thought of marketing Vietnam as a convention site? Do you have convention MICE facilities, let's say?
That's one of the difficulties that Vietnam is facing, and we are like not in competition with Thailand or Malaysia or Indonesia. We are still like weak in that term of infrastructures and facilities. Let's say in Hanoi, we got only about less than 10 five-star hotel, and we welcome lots of visitors, and sometimes the price of the five-star hotel is about three times, four times expensive compared to Thailand, compared to Malaysia, which is like amazing. Even you pay like nearly half $1,000 for one night stay in a five-star hotel, which is not rewarding, which is not really good. Normally you pay that for about a week stay in Thailand.
So the problem is money, that's what you're saying.
Money is one thing, but it's from the policy in general. Vietnam is opened up to international investment is not for long, and we're still a communist country, and it's still a little bit for security that Vietnam had to do. I think in the future, they might open more to more people, more investors coming. Or even like sometimes the procedures of investing might be a little bit complicated though Vietnamese government is already trying our best, but you know that the whole big country like Vietnam, I mean, big in terms of population, we have 86, 87 million people. With those number of people, it's already make the government a big headache already.